my problem today is with the entire U.S. policy in Cuba, which seems lately to be based on denying the country food and medicine and this dim hope that the Cubans are going to revolt against Fidel Castro, something they haven't seemed to manage to do for the last 30 years, or 40 years, and something which they show no signs of doing today. Why it would be illegal to tune pianos in Cuba. They don't know what, they don't have tuning with the enemy laws in most other countries.
Be the only American granted permission to ship goods to Cuba in more than 30 years. Ben Treuhaft is a California piano tuner, and he's just delivered 22 pianos and a truckload of replacement parts to Havana. Mr. Treuhaft is the son of social critic Jessica Mitford. We reached him in Berkeley, where he's in the process of rounding up even more pianos.
Cuban pianos are all eaten by termites, and the strings are rusted through with the salt air, and they haven't been able to order new parts. They need pianos because Cuba is dotted with broken pianos, termite-infested pianos, Russian pianos, which weren't very good to begin with, old American pianos that are completely rotted out.
Muy caro, y en estos momentos nosotros estamos utilizando los instrumentos, este mismo es de principio del siglo, es decir, estamos utilizando instrumentos que ya están muy viejos. Hace muchos años que no entran instrumentos a Cuba buenos, del piano al piano, por el clima que tenemos, un clima húmedo, coge comején muy rápido.
My Piano to Havana project started as a kind of enema for the Clinton administration's blocked-up Cuba policy, a way to draw attention to the unpopular U.S. trade embargo against Cuba. The Constitution doesn't allow the U.S. to make it exactly illegal for Americans to go to Cuba, so they've got around it by making it illegal for Americans to spend any money there at all. They can fine you thousands of dollars or throw you in jail. But after the U.S. Treasury threatened me with jail and fines, we got lots of publicity and support from around the world. It got me another batch of donated pianos, so many that it's time for another trip. There's a 40-foot container that's being loaded yesterday and today, full of 23 pianos, tons of related supplies, and there's going to be a second international piano tuners brigade to Cuba. The first one had 7 tuners, and this one has 20.
How is this container getting there?
This time it's going by rail to through Canada to Halifax, to the other end of Canada. And there's a mining company, a huge Canadian mining company, who has agreed to take it for free.
Fireman.
Yeah, because they're having a dispute with the U.S. anyway. They don't want publicity, but they also don't mind bringing pianos to Cuba against, I don't know, U.S. anti-musical interests or something. You were saying that the whole thing is smacks of paternalism.
Yes.
Is it paternalism? It's like, there's like extra pianos in one rich country and this other musical country that doesn't have any pianos?
Well, yes.
And then you send them over there? Because...
In a sense, that's sort of paternalism, in that we have so much waste and so much like overflow of everything we're consuming. And just sort of, I mean, where would these things all go? I don't know, some trash heap somewhere.
Or piano. I don't think
that's necessarily paternalistic if you...
We have so much, we can just like vomit this stuff onto you, like onto your little island here, like in container after container, regardless of what, you know, our government says, you know, the supposedly strongest government in the world.
The man who talked to the Russians plainly, firmly, and meant every word he said is the hero of America and is fervently thanked by the great majority of the
world. The trade embargo started with John Kennedy in the early 60s, and it started as part of the campaign to end the socialist experiment right near our shores. It's been going on for all that time, over 30 years, and part of the embargo is the ban against traveling to Cuba. They call it trading with the enemy.
El bloqueo, o el embargo, como se quiera llamar, no ataca solo al estómago de las personas. El bloqueo pretende silenciar nuestra cultura.
Hi, can I speak to Sandra? This is Ben, the piano man from Havana. I'm her piano tuner.
Yeah.
We're trying to, you know, we have this piano campaign to Cuba, and we're sort of out of money. And I noticed from looking at her house that she has a bit, and I was going to ask her for some for our campaign. I think she's already actually given us some, but anyway, I'm going to ask her again.
Okay.
All right. Thanks a lot.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye. Next victim. Let's write Senator Torres.
He's in trouble because of the embargo. The embargo prohibits American citizens not from traveling to Cuba, but from spending money there. So our official foreign policy is to destroy the economy of Cuba and have it plunge into poverty and collapse, and then in the traditional U.S. method, send in the Marines, appoint a new government, and so on and so forth.
Thank you.
I turned myself into the hotline for reporting people that travel illegally to Cuba. It's a new thing they set up, and I took advantage of it. And when they didn't call back, I sent them a Cuban peso convertible, which is like a dollar that Cuba makes to exchange for U.S. dollars. You can only get that by trading with the enemy. And a receipt from the Burgi, which is a very lowly burger joint, where we bought some milkshakes that my friend Santiago likes. And then they hit the roof when they got that, and they hit me with a $10,000 threat of a fine, and they said, I have 30 days to explain myself.
We make no apologies about the fact that we want to keep our external pressure. I mean, it's not directed at a piano tuner. It's directed at businessmen who want to go in there and profit from the lack of labor rights of the Cuban people. I mean, it's very clear, our policy. You know, you could go out and find a piano tuner. I think I saw a piano tuner on a network television show, and I have no pity for the piano tuner. I mean, you know, I'm sure he can tune plenty of pianos.
When the $10,000 fine first came down, my mother said, oh, Bench, how could you? Just when it was going so well and you had all those pianos going over there, why did you have to turn yourself into the Treasury hotline? And then when she saw the avalanche of pro-Cuba publicity that got from that, she changed her tune right away. They're confused. They offered the hearing, but when I said, okay, I'll have a hearing, then they said, oh, sorry, we don't know how to conduct a hearing because we've never had one before.
It's definitely a David and Goliath situation, and he's brought the U.S. government to its knees. They are refusing to have a hearing. They don't communicate with us anymore. When we call them, we're told that they still haven't decided what to do. And obviously, from that behavior, it's an embarrassment, and they'd like Ben to go away, but he's not going to go away.
Transbordador a descargar la carreta, me voy al transbordador a descargar la carreta para cumplir con la meta de mi penosa labor. A caballo vamos pa'l monte, a caballo vamos pa'l monte, a caballo vamos pa'l monte, a caballo vamos pa'l monte. Oh, maguajiro. Yo trabajo sin reposo para poderme casar, que yo trabajo sin reposo para poderme casar, y si lo llego a lograr seré un guajiro dichoso. A caballo vamos pa'l monte, a caballo vamos pa'l monte, a caballo vamos pa'l monte, a caballo vamos pa'l monte.
Nosotros cuando tocamos el piano nos sentimos muy despejados, muy bien. Nos sentimos como la gente va a un bar a tomar whisky, ron y eso. Así nos sentimos en el piano.
¿Es tu droga?
La droga de nosotros y la bebida de nosotros. Y la familia de nosotros, y el padre de nosotros, etcétera, etcétera, es el piano.
Thank you.
finally arrived. We've escaped from the red tape that held us up in Mexico for 2 days. The container should be here ahead of us, waiting for us to unload. For most of these guys, it's their first time in Cuba. I'm going to have to break them in on how to bless the rum and how to drink it down. The commie system here wouldn't allow us to give our pianos straight out to individuals. We're here as guests of the Cuban Institute of Music, so we're working closely with them. They should know where the container is.
El contenedor para nosotros. Ah, sí. María, el puerto de María. Pues antes, antes de todo. Gracias.
Durante estos 39 años de la revolución, el apoyo a la cultura y en particular al apoyo de la música desde el punto de vista gubernamental, desde el punto de vista estatal, ha sido fantástico. Este lugar donde nos encontramos, que otrora fuera el selecto country club de La Habana, donde únicamente, bueno, los norteamericanos que venían, incluso personalidades insignes y la más rancia sociedad cubana, podía tener acceso a este lugar. La revolución lo convirtió, dada la belleza del lugar, dada la belleza del entorno, concibió que fuera el lugar ideal para que se formaran nuestros artistas, nuestros estudiantes de artes plásticas, de ballet, de danza, de teatro y de música.
¿Por qué hay tanto problema para tener piano? Porque no entra ni un solo piano. Benjamín está donando piano por allá por la escuela de arte, pero Benjamín parece que no se sabe esta pequeña escuela la dirección. Pero bueno, y yo no sé la donación de piano cuánto le costaría. Pero ahora Benjamín dona los pianos por allá en una escuela que a los 2 meses en esa escuela no hay piano. Donde hay perritos, las matas no crecen. No sé si ustedes me entienden en filosofía lo que quiero decir. Las matas no prenden donde hay perritos. Es lo que yo me refiero con los pianos. Hacía falta de que esa donación de piano sea en general y no metido en una escuelita por ahí.
¿Cuánto es una cuerda sola?
We've been here for 3 days, but we're still waiting for the container. So for now, we're hanging around, working on the dregs of the pianos left over from past shipments. The tuners are getting pissed off with me. Some of them are starting to fan out over the music school, looking for pianos to fix. It's great, actually.
I hate saxophones. Most people play a saxophone as loud and as hard as they can. Don't go for a musical sound, they just go for a blat. And it drives piano tuners crazy. Especially this one.
Yeah, it's not coming today, tomorrow. And they couldn't get it today because they hadn't noticed on the bill of lading that it's a 40-foot container, not a 20-foot container. And their truck couldn't, they drove away with it and they only got a few blocks before it ground to a halt and they realized they couldn't bring it up here. So they're renting it one. I just gave them a couple hundred bucks to rent a real truck tomorrow morning at 7 o'clock or something like that.
And where does the machine go?
I told Santiago not to come back here without it.
The comején are a huge problem in Cuba. They're termites or carpenter ants whose favorite food is leg of piano. We've brought Rosa Loewinger over. She's a museum conservationist. She's world class. She's Cuban American. And she's studying the problem.
¿Cuál es el porciento de pianos en Cuba que tienen comején? 90.
No.
No tanto. Bueno, en las casas, todo el mundo que yo conozco. Todo el mundo que yo conozco que tiene piano en su casa dice que tiene comején.
Muchas veces las personas lo ubican en lugares donde hay mucha humedad y ese es el primer factor que ellos necesitan para poder sobrevivir, en lugares húmedos. Esto también tiene que ver con la naturaleza de la madera y la calidad del piano. Por ejemplo, un Steinway es mucho más resistente al adquirir, porque bueno, las maderas con que han sido fabricados son mucho más resistentes que, por ejemplo, otro tipo de piano. Mm. Por ejemplo, un Mokpa que aquí entraron en cantidades que, bueno, ya en 3 años estaba prácticamente deteriorado.
Experta en restauración del piano.
Ah, Daliberti, ¿vale?
¿Es Daliberti?
Sí, Daliberti. ¿Y es la maestra del niño?
Buenas. Mucho gusto, Bárbara.
Rosa.
Encantada.
Se ha hecho paciente.
Mira esto. A ver qué puede hacer, si tiene cura este paciente.
Este está un poco casi muerto, pero...
Terapia intensiva.
Sí. ¿Lo tiene por el mueble solamente o también por dentro?
Por dentro, por dentro.
¿Está afectando el sonido ya?
Sí, todo tiene. Afecta y están los martinetes ya que no funcionan. Por...
Ay, mi madre, mira.
¿Viste esto. Cómo está?
Sí, está muy mal.
Las comidas todas.
Sí, está todo comido por dentro aquí. No sé, si ustedes seguro que saben eso. No, lo que pasa es que una pareja se engancha y luego buscan un lugar en la madera que esté sin barniz, que puedan entrar, que no esté protegido. Ellas entran, la pareja entra y sellan ese huequito inmediatamente. Y uno se da cuenta que eso está ahí cuando ya han comido, se han comido un canal grande y están a punto de botar todo lo que no han comido por el otro lado. Y ahí está la cosa, ya cuando uno se da cuenta que eso existe, está...
Ya está el mal hecho,
entonces
sí.
la cosa con este piano tendría que ser una reparación súper, súper intensiva, con casi cambiarle el mueble y las piezas y todo. Porque miren, yo traigo materiales para buscar como ejemplo, aquí no hay que buscar. Aquí,
no está en la
aquí
vista.
Aquí está esto...
Invadido.
Sí. Y aún puede tocar este piano. Yo,
no,
a mí yo,
quiere,
ay, me encantaría.
Como él
estaría feliz
toca,
para la vida entera.
Bueno, toca gitanería de la cubana y así dice que le gusta la cuna, para que vea cuántas notas hay ya que nos suenan y en fin.
Sí.
Verás cómo está el teclado. Entonces, inclusive para su oído le está afectando eso, porque claro, eso desvirtúa claro. El sonido
claro,
como tal.
Claro.
Es decir, que ya, en lugar de ayudarlo, lo perjudica.
Estoy un poco emocionada en este momento, sí. Realmente, porque está lindísimo. Como tú, como.
Ya verás cómo.
Rosa.
Sí.
¿Puedes
hablar sobre el piano? ¿Puedes hablar sobre el piano? ¿Puedes hablar sobre el piano? ¿Puedes hablar sobre el piano? ¿Puedes hablar sobre el piano? ¿Puedes hablar I'm amazed that he can play this piano at all. It's really obviously it's just in terrible condition. Its termite damage is just extreme. I've really never seen damage quite that excessive in anything, any piano or anything else. It's probably quite beyond repair in that sense, unless it was just rebuilt. In a major fashion. I mean, I just feel like he has to have a new piano. It just seems to me that, obviously, if he doesn't, but this is a very bad situation for someone like him. And his teacher was explaining to me that, you know, it compromises his ear. He just played an amazing piece of music that really was extraordinary, and it was completely off everywhere, you know, but you could just hear it through how bad the piano was. It's quite an amazing thing. I mean, in any other country but Cuba, this piano would be gone. It's just that people make do here, really, with things that are not useful in other contexts. There's a lot of need.
Había un valle de dolor y yo le contesté, no me amargues la vida, tal parece mentira, eso mismo soñé. Corazón, yo que tanto he sufrido por la dicha que nunca encontré. Corazón, si es de vago perdido, dale fuerza que aliente mi fe. Corazón, ten valor, no te afligas. hija, yo las penas por siempre olvidé. No me hables de cosas tan tristes, corazón, nunca pierdas la fe. No me hables de cosas tan tristes, corazón, nunca pierdas la fe. Thank you.
So a week into the trip, a week late, the pianos are finally here. So what happens now?
¿Cómo yo recojo esos pianos de la ENA? Porque a la vez que entra la ENA, se convierte estatal. Y los estatales, el Estado, te quitan, no te dan los pianos. ¿Cómo yo rescato esos 25 pianos?
Mira, los pianos de la donación, no tenemos bastante pianos para todo el mundo cubano.
Claro, pues,
hay 11 millones cubanos y muchos tocan piano. Pero el proyecto tiene pianos bastante para algunas escuelas y para una iglesia. Y posiblemente, no sé.
No alcance los pianos.
¿Cómo?
Que no va a alcanzar los pianos.
¿Cuál
que
es se alcanzar?
Alcanzar quiere decir que usted va a traer 60 pianos total.
Sí.
Y puede ser que no alcance esos pianos.
Alcanzar.
Alcanzar piano quiere decir que si son 60 y no alcance, dentro de 6 meses o un año, hay que traer 20 pianos más, digamos, porque no alcanzó los pianos para la iglesia, para la banda de música, para la escuela, para la escuelita de Arcadio, etcétera, etcétera.
Okay. While the problem of who gets these pianos is still being sorted out, I'm off to visit Yvonne and Yvette. Yvette is a music teacher, and she was the last person that we were able to give a piano to. She won it in a contest. It had to be completely dismantled to fit through the thin door of her house. She gave us tuners rum and sandwiches. Now that it's in the hands of Cuban officials, I often worry that the pianos will get lost in paperwork. It seems that three from an earlier batch have been drowned in a flood at the State Piano Workshop, and that one of the best grand pianos has been sent someplace before we had a chance to work it over. About a year ago, I had a minor battle with the heads of the Cuban Institute of Music about the distribution of the pianos. I wanted them to go to individual kids. They preferred them to go to schools. We agreed to split them between schools and students who would win them in contests. It looks like they've stopped having the contests, which is too bad. They were great, and it makes really good press back home.
Thank you. del campo socialista se cae todo. Aquí contábamos con talleres con una entrada de pianos bastante fija, estable, de los países socialistas, Checoslovaquia, Unión Soviética, Bulgaria, en fin. Al suceder esto, se suspende la entrada de pianos a Cuba, de accesorios que necesitaran los pianos, lo que fuese, de todo tipo de ayuda para poder mantener todo lo que teníamos. Al suceder esto, bueno, sucede como un colapso, ¿no?
The problem in the schools is so great that our 60 pianos won't make much of a dent. There are shortages of just about every instrument in every school on the island.
Entonces nosotros tratamos de hacerlo, inventar cualquier cosa. Por ejemplo, mira, en violín, es que es en las cuerdas. Por ejemplo, el cuerda mi en violín es muy, muy difícil. Ahora no hay cuerdas. Entonces, y esta cuerda mi es muy específica porque como aquí hay mucha humedad, se pudre y se rompe enseguida. Entonces, que mismo los cubanos inventaron lo mismo, el cable de teléfono. Hay un cable de teléfono que tiene que un cable específico que se puede, entonces lo pica los pedazos, lo acomode. Claro que es muy peligroso porque el cable no es la misma cuerda. Cuando el niño chiquito utiliza, entonces puede lastimar el dedo porque el cable es cable y la cuerda es cuerda.
The closest thing we've got to an embassy here in Cuba is the U.S. interest section. I know they have a great Steinway, so I'm going to go see if I can get it off them.
¿Quieres saber por qué estoy aquí? No. ¿Sí? Es solo para, no es malo, es solo para hablar con ellos y ver si ellos tienen unos pianos para darnos a los músicos cubanos. Porque yo tengo un proyecto, se llama Un Piano para Cuba, y ellos me conocen ya. Compañero. Discúlpeme. Oye, mira.
Hay pasaporte.
Mira. In order to get into the embassy, you have to show a passport, which luckily I had. They were totally floored that I had a passport. Now the guy's on the phone trying to explain that a piano in the form of a person with a U.S. passport wants to enter the embassy. And it's taking a while.
You have to call him by the telephone. Our telephone is 333-967.
And when?
To make an appointment with
him. Oh, okay.
Because now he's busy.
Okay, and can you ask him to call me too? Mm-hmm. Here's my number here.
Anyhow.
Fantástico. Muchas gracias.
No,
disculpe mi
no.
Traje.
No.
Es un traje de...
No, muy peculiar.
Thank you. curious about where the pianos end up. I know that they get distributed to schools, but I want to know the addresses. I want to be able to take pictures of each piano in the school, not because I mistrust the Institute of Music. I think they're going to be giving them to people that shouldn't be getting them, but just because I want to see, just for the fun of it, where they're ending up, so that the people that give me the pianos will be able to one day get a picture of their piano being played by a Cuban musician. It'd be great for collecting more pianos back home.
Necesitamos piano americano, made in USA, de Nueva York.
Hay que romper el bloqueo.
Bueno, estamos en eso.
Estamos luchando
para eso. Ese bloqueo no se rompe más nunca. No se sabe por dónde se va a romper el bloqueo.
Estamos luchando.
Quizás con los pianos rompemos el bloqueo.
Quizás.
Sí, porque el piano es una cosa sedante, relajante. Quien no toque un bar de Chopin, digamos, no se siente feliz con el piano. Por eso carecemos de los pianos, y los pianos nos van a ayudar a romper el bloqueo.
Ya está. Cuatro, te dije.
¿Qué?
I usually write a postcard to my senator. This one's to Senator Torricelli. He always likes it when he gets one from the Jose Marti Airport. This one says, "Dear Senator Torricelli, having a wonderful time. The people here are hungry because of the Cuba Democracy Act, but they are not defeated. Sorry, Ben. P.S. And they never will be." Here's one to Bill Clinton. It's got naked ladies. I don't know. "Dear Bill, kiss my ass. Ben Treuhaft," in my address. Aquí, aquí, por aquí. ¡Viva Cuba!